Hello, everyone. My name is Edward McCarver, and we're going to spend some time talking about an event that's coming to Wallingford on April 6th and 7th and 8th. The Wallingford Community Theater is presenting Ken Ludwig's Lend Me a Tenor. It will be held at the Library Wine Bar and Bistro, which is located on 60 North Main Street in Wallingford. Tickets are available at Gallagher Travel Shop, 369 Center Street, Wallingford, or online at wallingfordcomtheater.brownpapertickets.com, and we'll talk about that later because I'm sure I butchered that intro here. Tickets are $25, and we're privileged to have the director, a good friend of the station here, Mary Ellen Kingsland Eccles, and two of the actors, David Walton and Matthew Bennett. And welcome, and thank you for taking time out from, I think, what is a busy schedule now. As we tape this, it is less than 2 weeks before before opening. Give us a rundown. How's it going so far?
Oh, my gosh. I think it's going great. It's so funny. We're still laughing. During auditions, as people were reading the lines and as we rehearse the same scenes over and over, they're still so funny. So we're having a great time. Amazing cast.
Tell us a little bit about the history of the Wallingford Community Theater. I think it's something that was started by yourself, and just give us a little bit on the
10 years ago. This is our 10th anniversary, and so we're opening up our season this year with Lend Me a Tenor. We did Grease at Lyman Hall High School back in 2008, and every summer since we've had big, huge summer musical production, and 3 years ago we started the Repertory Theater division.
You did mention, and I wanted to touch on that, the play is performed by the Wallingford Community Theater's Repertory Group,
yes,
which is different than the summer theater, which usually has a cast of thousands, I think.
Yes.
It's like a children's theater. But is that the difference between a repertory group and a regular theater group?
Well, a repertory infers that you have an ensemble, a troupe, a corps of actors, and while ours is open at every audition to add new members to that, we have many of the same actors coming back each year, and they'll play different parts. Sometimes they'll be acting, sometimes they might be, like this year, one of our great actresses is stage manager. You know, so it's a real esprit de corps.
So
everybody has different rules, and it runs more like a professional theater.
So they get to play different roles other than working behind the stage,
rather than
up front. Okay. As we mentioned, the play is scheduled for April 6th, 7th, and 8th, which is a Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Curtain goes up at 8 o'clock. I think doors open at 7:30. Give us a quick overview of Lend Me a Tenor. Give us a synopsis of it.
I don't want to give away.
It's about a tenor.
Yes, it is about a tenor, and he goes missing. It's a classic farce. It's a very physical comedy. A lot of door slamming. It's won so many Tonys on Broadway. It's just hysterical. But basically, it's set in 1934 in, the Grand Opera House?
Cleveland Grand Opera House.
As you know, because he plays Saunders in this version of it. But you've also played other parts.
I have played others, yes.
Yeah.
Two of the main characters in the play are Saunders, who is the director of the Cleveland Opera Society, and his understudy, who is Max. And we have the two actors here that play both Saunders and Max. Saunders, Dave Walton, and Max, someone probably familiar to theater goers in this area,
oh, I'm sure.
Matthew Bennett. Dave, I'll start with you, if I may, because
sure,
you're the you're kind of making your debut with the Wallingford Theater Group.
I am.
Tell us a little bit about your history. When did you get involved in theater in general, how you got involved with Wallingford?
Well, I've been involved with theater for almost 30 years. How I even got involved in the first place or loving theater was my dad was a professional dancer when I was growing up. So I grew up with all the musicals and that sort of thing. I didn't get into acting until I was around 30, and So,
you so know, you've only been acting 4 or 5 years then.
Yeah,
yeah, well, two, but who's saying? You know, just in terms of getting involved with Wallingford, you know, I'm always looking for the various places that have auditions and things, and I happened to see that Lend Me a Tenor, which I absolutely loved the show, and I was fortunate to be in the show with a different group at about 7 or 8 years ago. And so when I saw the audition, and I actually saw it on the second night of auditions, like a couple of hours before it, so I had to kind of scramble to get here, and boy, am I glad I did. It's been phenomenal.
He is a delight. He's so
you.
Fun to work with.
And Matt, how did you get involved in the theater?
It started in high school, actually. The teacher who was doing the musical, I happened to be in a study hall with her as the teacher, and she was talking with someone who was in the musical, and they were complaining that there weren't enough guys, and I happened to just be sitting right there, so all of a sudden she looks up and just gets a big smile and goes, Matt! And I got roped in my senior year of high school to doing their musical and just kind of kept at it since then.
We're talking with Mary Ellen Kingsland Eccles, the director of Lend Me a Tenor, to be performed April 6th, 7th, and 8th at the Library Wine Bar and Bistro, 60 North Main Street in Wallingford. Tickets are $25. They're available at Gallagher Travel Shop and online. And Mary Ellen, maybe you can give that online, because I know I butchered it.
Well, it's Wallingford Com Theater with an R-E for the theater,
and
brownpapertickets.com, but maybe we can post the link or something.
Okay, yeah. Yep, we can do that when we finish up. I wanted to ask you, Mary Ellen, who decides on what plays to be formed? Is it your decision, or do you talk to the actors, or is there a group you...
We have a core team of leaders. Matt's one of them. Matt started out with us as an intern, and then... when he graduated with a theater degree, he came on staff with us. So Matt's done everything. I mean, he's like the perfect member in the theater. He's a great guy. So, you know, Matt's one of them. You know, Dave Stein is our set designer. He's an architect with Silver Petroselli and Associates. He's designed theaters. So we're so blessed to have him. He's enormously talented, very, very dedicated, great, passionate guy, really cares about the theater and what he's doing with us. And in the summertime, Megan Chertel, is also, you know, so we'll get together. For this one, it was basically Matt and Dave and I went to dinner at the Library Wine Bar and Bistro and sat down with a pile of scripts that I had purchased, and we go through them, and we just, you have to think of the venue, because it's, for those of you who live in Wallingford, it's the old children's library, and we literally build the set right there. We set up the audience. So you have to think what's going to work there. You obviously can't have huge set changes, so it's got to be something that works. This one's perfect. And actually, the final decision on this one, I gave Dave, I think I'd narrowed it down to about 2 or 3. I'd be happy with any of them. 2 of them happened to be Ken Ludwig's plays. I think Leading Ladies was the other one I was looking at. And Dave basically said, this is the one I know we can design the set for. And Matt thinks about the lighting and all the technical, because he's always our, in addition to acting and everything else he does, he's also our technical director.
Did you want to do a comedy? I know you did.
Yes.
Brighton Beach last year.
Yeah, that was so funny.
And the year
that
before
great.
That, I think, was The Straw.
It was The
which
Straw,
is kind
which
of
is
heavy.
Not funny. Yeah, quite the opposite. Yeah. But we chose The Straw because it was our first year. Eugene O'Neill wrote that on his experiences staying at Gaylord when he had tuberculosis and falling in love with the woman he eventually married when they both got well. Although I think she doesn't. I'm trying to remember in the play. They don't make it clear, but she doesn't. In the play, you get the feeling that she doesn't survive the tuberculosis, but in real life, she does, and they get married. And I think his son taught at Yale. Their son taught
right?
at Yale. Yeah, I think he was a professor at Yale. But anyway, so that one we chose because of the history. We thought it was a nice beginning. But And it, as much as he enjoyed it, Joe Gouveia, who's amazing, he is so generous to rehearse and perform in such a gorgeous renovated building that has such significance to any of us who grew up in Wallingford. You know, we all went there to do our senior term paper. You know,
yes, we did.
We told our parents we had to go there every night because we were working so hard on that paper.
Back at Robert Early Junior High School, the after-school fistfights used to be behind the library.
Oh, is that right?
I had several losses behind that.
I was a Yale's little girl. Yeah. I didn't know that.
I wanted to ask both actors, and I'll start with you, Matt, if I may.
Sure.
You've both done comedy and drama productions. In your opinion, what's the tougher to perform? Is it comedy or is it?
I would probably say comedy. Getting the timing down to make the jokes work and everything makes it a lot more difficult than dramatic stuff. It's pretty easy to act like something's terrible and wrong and be dramatic, but to get the perfect timing for a joke is a lot more difficult, and it takes a lot more rehearsing than any dramatic piece would.
And Dave, would you agree?
Yeah. You know, I've done several dramas also, and where it might actually be a little fun to be angry or yell or excuse me, or you know, take something out of on someone. The timing in a comedy is so much more critical. Because, you know, if you're off a second, whatever that particular moment is in that show, it could be totally gone, totally missed. The timing is absolutely everything.
So the timing would not be as important in a drama production.
Well, it's a different kind of thing. It's
the timing in comedy has to be spot on. Mm-hmm. I remember in college, in one of my acting classes, they talked about that, and they said that if you've got an actor who can really do comedy well, really has the timing. A lot of people feel that the timing, you're born with it, you know. And I think it is easier for some folks than others. I think, but I remember them saying that a good comedic actor will be also a fabulous dramatic actor, but a dramatic actor doesn't always make a good comedy actor. They just don't have that timing. It's very easy. Like sometimes even during our rehearsals, I'd have to say, "Be careful! You have to lighten it up. It's starting to go to a darker place," you know. And that's not what it's about at all. So it really is something. I don't know. I think you feel it. I think you feel the timing.
And it's also, I think, when you do a farce type of comedy, the timing is even that much more critical.
And this kind of comedy, because you have a cast of 8 or 10 people with lots of quick entrances and exits, doors slamming, lines are timed off each other, the energy has to be high, it has to be really, really fast. We worked very, very hard on that with the entire cast. You have to keep that tempo up, you have to keep the timing going, because if it slows down, it's not, all of a sudden you lose the humor. You know, and a lot of, when you do it right, the physical comedy just happens with it, you know.
Right. We're talking
which
with
you do very well, by the way.
Go ahead. The check's in the mail.
Ed plays the tenor we're looking for. He plays Tito Morelli, and you do a fabulous job with it.
Well, it's a lot of fun. If I can be a little self-indulgent for
oh, please do.
For
you
a
do
moment.
An amazing
I,
job.
I owe it all to Mike Trzynski, who couple of seasons ago, if I may,
sure.
When they were performing Happy Days, I was at the checkout line at Stop and Shop. And
it's where all good things happen. Yeah.
And Mike had said to me, you know, do you do any acting? And I said, well, I'm a standardized patient at Quinnipiac University. I says, you've got a disease? I could do it. So, you know. And Matt said, well, we... We're doing Happy Days, and we needed Arnold. And he says, it's Mary Ellen Kingsland, Eccles. I says, I'm in. I know Mary Ellen. So I went up, and the rest is history.
Yeah,
so since
you
then,
were great.
I did Willy Wonka last year, fell in love with it.
Grandpa Joe.
Yep. And now it lent me a tenor, and it is so much fun.
Well, you're a natural.
But
thank
you for the plug. We're talking about Lend Me a Tenor at the April 6th, 7th, and 8th at the Library Wine Bar and Bistro, 60 North Main Street in Wallingford. Mary Ellen, talk a little bit about that location at 60 North Main Street. How did you pick that location, and how was it received for Brighton Beach, and how many people does it fit?
Well, it is a small venue. I'd say 80 to 90 people in the audience. We actually, it kind of came to, it was really perfect synergy. We had been wanting to start our repertory theater. We felt at that point we'd been about 7 years doing the summer shows. We were really ready to start providing something more for the adults. In town, it's wonderful. The summer, you know, hundreds of kids, hundreds of teenagers, 25 adults or something like that, you know, in the summertime, big flashy musical, and that's great. And we pack the high schools, and it's wonderful. But we were ready to kind of reach out to the adults in town and say, you don't have to necessarily, you know, drive out of town to have a really fabulous dinner. We have so many wonderful restaurants. And see a really great show. And we've been very blessed because we're pulling tremendous talent from all over the state. I'm at auditions, I'm always floored by that. But Joe Gouveia was still renovating, and he had mentioned in an interview in the newspaper that he would love it to be a place where the arts could come and have a place to, you know, perform or display their work. And so Dave Stein and I set up a meeting with him, and we met him at the library, Wine Bar and Bistro, when it was not completed yet. It was basically, you know, the walls were barely up and the big wires were hanging from the ceiling and stuff. But you could see in the rooms that were done already, it was gorgeous. Oh my gosh. The attention to detail that they took renovating that. I don't even think the original building was that gorgeous. I mean, it really reflects that era, but it was built originally as a library, and I'm thinking back as a kid, we always thought it was a great-looking place, but yeah, it's breathtaking now, yeah, and to be able to rehearse and then to perform there is such a gift.
I wanted to ask both the actors. We mentioned that the library bar location is kind of a smaller or intimate crowd. Do you have a preference as a performer? Do you prefer a smaller crowd like the bistro or an auditorium-like setting? And does each have its advantages or disadvantages? And
do you want to go first?
Sure. I don't know that I have a preference. I think it depends on the show. Like this show in particular, I think, works better with this smaller audience, with them closer up to the action, to feel like they're right there and part of it. Mm. Whereas if we put this on a stage like any of the high schools or anything, they would be so far back from us and so distanced from all the action and everything that it might lose some of the comedy and some of the timing. So for something like this, a smaller, intimate space really does work well. But you know, when you come to like the musicals that we do in the summer, it's always better to have that big space to fill it with families of everyone in the show and to have a lot of space to make a big number with a lot of people on stage and everything. So,
yeah, I think I agree with Matt, but one other thing that I always found very interesting, and this has been a constant for as long as I've been doing theater, is the energy that you get from the audience is really, I think, such a motivator when you're on stage. Mm. And you can have, I've done shows where there's been 30 people in the audience, and they have been one of the best audiences ever. And I've been in shows where you've had 300 people, and their energy level is down, and it's very difficult, or more difficult on stage, to maintain that level. So I'm actually really looking forward to this venue. You know, it's you know, as Matt said, you know, it's this kind of show. I think works perfectly in a smaller situation.
So you can literally,
the audience is right up there, right next to you. They're gonna, you know, they're gonna be as close as you and I are.
And yeah, you could feed off that energy.
Absolutely.
As an actor.
No question. Yeah. You absolutely can.
Again, we're speaking with members of the Wallingford Community Theater for Lend Me a Tenor. April 6th, 7th, and 8th at 8 o'clock p.m. at the Library Wine Bar and Bistro, 60 North Main Street in Wallingford. Tickets are available at Gallagher Travel Shop and WallingfordComTheater.brownpapertickets.com. Someone asked me if tickets would be available at the door tonight. Is that kind of a crapshoot?
We've usually sold out before we get that far. And Wallingford, it used to make me really, really nervous at first because it would, like, there'd be a lot of tickets sold and then nothing. It'd be like crickets for a couple of weeks, and then we'd go, oh, no, no. I'm going to have to go, like, hand tickets out to people on the street. And then all of a sudden, a week or two before, boom, they're gone. You know? Like, I just got a call this morning. I just brought a bunch of tickets, actually, to Amici Salon okay. and Spa on North Main Street Extension, which is in that little plaza. They have a few tickets to sell. The online is the easiest, but we tried to make paper tickets available this time because this is the first year we've done both for the repertory. We always do both for the summer. I think a lot of people just really like to just go and get those tickets. So if we have any left over, we'll sell them at the door. Okay. But we haven't had to ever
you
do that.
You can't guarantee it.
Well, we've never had any left to do that. Okay. So, yeah. And I honestly, not to, you know, cut anybody out of the fun, but I kind of hope that. I hope we're sold out before we get to that point, yeah. today, as it is.
I wanted to ask, last year you did Brighton Beach Memoirs.
Yeah.
And I remember you sat in that chair last year and you told us Neil Simon might not be appropriate for some younger
right.
viewers.
Well, that particular one.
Yeah. Is Lend Me a Tenor kind of fall in that category as well?
I think so. It's really, repertory has always been intended to be more for the adults, young adults and adults. I would say the age, I mean, what we have listed on Brown Paper Tickets is age 14 and up.
Okay.
I do tend to tame down some of the language sometimes when I do plays and stuff, and I have a little tiny bit in this one, but I don't know, some of those B words are so perfectly timed. I really didn't want to mess with the comedy with that one. But I would say 14 and up. There's no themes going on in there that probably an 8-year-old could handle them, but, you know, unfortunately today. But I would say 14 and up.
Okay. Okay. I want to go back to the actors, and I wanted to ask both Dave and Matt, what's the most difficult part of performing in a play? Is it actually the fact of memorizing the lines, or is there anything else what causes the biggest nerves before you step on the stage?
I don't know. I think for me, it's before I, you know, once I get cast in a show, I always worry, I'll never remember the lines that I have. And that could be, I could have 10 lines, or I could have, you know, 100 pages of lines, and I have the same thought process. But I think sometimes what it is for me, is making sure we have, that if something goes wrong on stage, you know, a prop isn't there, something on the set goes, somebody does forget a line, because it's happened to every single actor in every
Absolutely.
Single show, I guarantee it, and the audience 99.9 times will never notice that. But I think it's the toughest thing is the ability to be able to improvise if you have to.
Yep.
And you know, and but that's also kind of part of the fun too. You know, so it's. But I think for me that's what it is.
And Matt, would you agree with that?
Yeah, the improvising whenever there's a drop line or something is definitely a fun little challenge and everything. I think for me it's usually opening night. That first performance is kind of the one that sets the tone of everything. Mm-hmm. And once I get through that show, like, I'm good for the rest of the run of the show and everything. But it's always a bit more nerve-wracking when you're first opening the show and everything.
And I don't think you ever lose that. I mean, I've been on the stage since I was 3, and I remember being on the stage at Southern and still, like, petrified. The overture's playing, you're standing on the stage waiting for the curtains to open for your cue, and it's just like, you know.
I was, it's that adrenaline rush.
Yes.
That's what it is.
But then you you push through it, and you say your first couple lines, or you do whatever you have to do, and you're good. Yeah.
But I've also heard people say, and it's before a race, I'll be nervous, but people say it keeps you on your game.
Yeah.
If you're not nervous
before
an athletic
or a play, that it would be.
I mean, think about how laid back and dispassionate you must be to not be nervous before you perform. I've never seen a good actor or talked to a good actor who doesn't get nervous at some point in the process.
Especially in the summers. When we have a lot of young actors, they'll come up to me and be like, I'm so nervous during the shows and everything. I'll tell them, good, use that. That's your adrenaline.
And
that'll help
surprised.
You perform better and everything. And they're like, wait, you're nervous too? And I'm like, yeah. And they look to me because I have a bit more experience than some of them and everything. But I don't think they first realize that. It's good to be that to have some nerves to push yourself to perform even better at it and everything. Yeah.
Actually, that's kind of the perfect segue into my next question I had. And again, we're talking to members of the Wallingford Community Theater, presenting Lend Me a Tenor, April 6th, 7th, and 8th at 8 o'clock p.m. at the Library Wine Bar and Bistro. Someone goes to the play, enjoys it, wants to get involved in the summer production or get involved with the Wallingford Community Theater.
Great.
What would they do?
Well, we have a Facebook page. That's probably the best place to go for current information, you know, like what's happening now, what's going to happen in the next month or a couple of weeks or something. We have a website too, but that's more for archives, I think, you know, for what we've done over the years. You can be involved on the stage, but I'd say if we have 150 people on the stage, we easily have 200, 250 involved behind the scenes. So there's no matter what your walk of life, no matter what your life skills, you know, experiences, there's something that you could do. And it is a big family. We really push that.
I do want to mention that you do not have to be a Wallingford resident per se part of Wallingford
you
Theater.
Do not.
Theater.
You
okay.
do not. Yeah.
Okay.
I can vouch for that.
Okay. We have less than 3 minutes, according to our crack staff in the booth. Is that correct, Tom? Can we talk? Is it too early to talk about the summer productions? I remember the last time you were here, you told us what was
that's right.
What was going on this summer.
You never say anything. Yeah.
Careful, ratings bombshell.
Yeah, I know. Whatever. Yeah. It's our 10th year, so we are going to have a huge show this summer. I'm excited, and I'm excited for the kids and the teens especially, because we are going to do our favorite scenes and production numbers from shows throughout our 10 years. So we'll have different sets of leads for, you know, lots of different moments. And we're tying it all together with some great comedy and some amazingly talented actors.
Excellent. Excellent.
I got them to come back.
Very, very quickly, best advice you ever received as an actor? And what advice would you give someone who wants to be the next Dave or Matt?
Just be the character and know that you can do it. Have the confidence in yourself to be able to do it.
I think the advice I would give is what I had said earlier, is if you're nervous, use that and everything and
Absolutely.
Let that be part of it. Mm-hmm. And really the best advice that I've ever received is basically just to not give up on it. It's a hard business to get into. You're going to get rejected quite a bit, but if you keep trying, eventually you'll find something that you fit into.
Mary Ellen, you're shaking your head, so you agree
with
that?
Yeah, no, I do. I do. Something I say all the time that probably is maybe my best advice to anybody, experienced or not, is to trust yourself. It's a risk. It's a leap of faith. Just do it. It's like jumping into the cold pool of water. Just do it, because it's great once you're in. And to trust yourself. So many times, we have some brand new actors with us, and they have never done anything before. Their instincts are right. They're holding back because they're not trusting themselves. So I keep telling them over and over again, trust yourself, trust yourself. You're right, trust yourself.
All right, for one final time, Wallingford Community Theater, Lend Me a Tenor, April 6th, 7th, and 8th, 8 o'clock p.m., the Library Wine Bar and Bistro, 60 North Main Street in Wallingford. Mary Ellen, Dave, Matt, thank you very much.
Well,
thank you, Ed,
for today and for all the work you're doing in this show.
So thank you.
He's worth the price of the ticket. He really is.
And special credit for Tom Brady behind the booth, or as we like to call him, the good Tom Brady, behind the booth there. Thank you, Tom.
Thanks, Tom.
All right. And we'll see you soon.